Shalom, shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, you're not under the sounds of your voice of your brother, Kahan Tazadaq. I'm coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, through the spirit of righteousness and truth. What I'm about to give you is not legal advice. What I'm about to give you is for educational, informational, and to those of you that like to be entertained, entertainment purposes only. But what I'm about to give you, this is from the heart, and my intent is to help those of you that continuously get stuck. You keep getting stuck. This will help you alter your life or where you are right now. Now, many of you, you know, you contact me in regard to commercial presentment. Secured party creditor. There's some of you out there that's actually you've actually donated. You know, you have your packet, but you do not have the heart to go forward. And then, you know, you get this information and you sit on it because you're controlled by your self-negation or you're manipulated by this false perception of reality that other people have painted and is keeping you stuck. It's keeping you stuck. And you keep talking about how things are not this way or that way for you. It's because it's your thinking. It's not me. It's not anyone else out there. It's you. You're the reason that you're consistently getting stuck. You're the reason that you're not a secured party creditor right now. You're the reason that you're in the bind that you're in. And then you'll wait until you're in dishonor. Oh, Tazadaq, maybe you can help me with this. I know I'm running a little late and so on and so forth. You're already in dishonor. So I keep telling you the same thing over and over. Do the work now, and you will take care of major problems in the future. Do the work now. Push past your fears. Push through the pain. Do the work now. You know my email. Creditors, debtors, contracts at yahoo.com. You want to become a creditor? Email me. If you want to stay stuck, you keep listening to the naysayers. And then 5 years from now, you're going to be in the same place that you are right now, stuck. You're going to be Joe average. Or you may be worse than average. But you will not progress as long as you continue to retain the same mindset. So this video is specifically, and I'm not going to be too long, but I promise to be strong. And if you listen to the information in this video, it will help you alter your life and show you how to be a winner and show you how to push through the pain and show you how to stop getting stuck and be great. Quitting is not an option. Now, I entitled this video, Why Some People Can't Change by Tazadaq. And share this video, like this video, share this video with as many people as you can because so many people out there need it. Now, there's no such thing as standing still in life. If you're moving forward, you're on a positive path. But if you're not moving forward, you're moving backwards. There is no such thing as standing still in life. So either you're moving forward or you're moving backwards. So it's baffling how many people, how some people seem to identify with problems in their lives. They decide they want to, you know, it's just mind-boggling. It's baffling how some people seem to identify a problem in their lives, like myself. I identify a problem. I go through the process of elimination. And I say to myself, how can I alter this problem? Because I know the resolution lies between my two ears. It's my thinking. So, but what continues to baffle me is that how some people can identify problems in their lives, decide that they want to change themselves, and start changing. Whereas there's other people, and this is the vast majority of people that actually contact me or that I encounter, Tazadaq, I want to become a secured party creditor. You talk about it, I never hear from them again. Others, they get the information and they sit on it for months. And they contact me at the month. And do you really think I'm going to assist you at the month? You've been sitting on this for 8 months? It's because of your thinking. You're blocking your own remedy with your thinking and listening to the naysayers. Do the work now. Do not sit on this. You're not promised tomorrow. You know, there's others. And these are the negative people that, you know, they see, they're so cynical and negative that if you were trying to give them something positive, like this, being a secured party creditor, you know, relieving yourself from the two major corporations that's controlling your lives that you refer to as Democratic Party and Republican Party. Those are corporations that's dictating your lives and causing much of the hell that you are actually undergoing right now. Two corporations known as the Democratic Party and the Republican Party, and you're fighting about which party you want to be in when both of them are corporations that's dictating your lives now, and you don't want to be free. You don't know how to be free because you keep listening to the naysayers. So there's some people that they don't seem to be able to take positive steps, like myself and like others that I know. This has been the case with man, you know, many of you that, again, want to be secured party creditors. Many of you have reached out. Many of you have invested the currency. Many of you have actually received information and you sit on that information. You sit on that paperwork. Why? Because you suffer from this fear of what may happen if you go forward with what you're supposed to do. So you listen to the naysayers, oh, this is going to happen to you. You're going to get locked up and so on and so forth. For what? For trying to be free? And many of you, you just, in your mind, you just create all of these fictitious, horrific stories that you think is going to happen to you. Oh, will this get cut off? Will I lose this benefit? And so on and so forth. Your thinking is preventing your remedy. Many of you, you receive information and you sit on it because old habits is blocking your remedy. Some of you still are sitting on documents that you received 6 months ago, 8 months ago, 15 months ago. You're still sitting on the documents. Oh, yeah, I'm going to get to it. Yeah, I'm sorry. I've been sitting on it. I've heard the stories over and over again. Yet you wonder why you're in dishonor and you want to blame me or someone else. But you are responsible for being stuck where you are. No one else. You are responsible. Why would you do this? It's because you cannot get unstuck from the mindset that have been programmed into you by the two major corporations. Democratic Party, Republican Party, is dictating your lives. These are corporations. And they have their political crooks therein. But if the people are not content with this, it is the people's responsibility to replace them with those that will perform their duties according to what the people see fit. This is what you have to move towards for, family. See, this is why you can't get unstuck. You've gotten comfortable with being average, or you've gotten comfortable with being below average, or you've gotten comfortable with being a failure. And I, family, I must say this. I must talk to you this way because you need it. This is the only thing that's going to motivate you and get you unstuck. You fear the unknown, therefore, you have not had the strength to push forward and follow your documents. You're sitting on them. Or you haven't made the donations. You come up with excuses. Or, I can't donate for this. But you could go and blow $100 on a pair of rubber sneakers because they have someone's name on them. Or on a pair of designer jeans because they have someone's name on them. They're no more valuable than the other sneakers or jeans. But because someone's name is on it and you idolize that person, you will go and give away your power. Remember, we're on the private side. So we need some medium of exchange. Don't contact me, oh, Tazadaq, can I use A for V to pay you. You don't understand the difference between public and private. I'm on the private side, brother. I'm out here with you in the struggle. No, it's quid pro quo. Something for something. Oh, well, and I love the idiots, the ID10Ts that like to say, well, if you was really doing this, you would do it for free. Listen, I've done that for 3 or 4 years straight. And the only thing that cost me was almost cost me my family for not spending time for helping those of you that they knew nothing back. Where were you when I was in trouble? See, our people love free handouts. You love free handouts. You love free. See, that's the price that everyone agrees with. It's free. But most of the things that you get, they don't have a monetary value or some other medium of exchange. It's not worth very much in this life. In this life. See, you want to wait until you see what happens to someone else, to everyone else, because you're cowardice. You've been taught to be a coward. You're comfortable even in your status, even if your status is not that good. You're comfortable with being where you are. Yes, I'm talking to many of you. The reason this is cutting you right now, because I'm talking to you. I'm talking to a lot of you out there right now. And you know who you are. This applies to you. Listen, family. I've grown to witness that some folks seem to stay stuck no matter how hard they try. They might read self-help books. They talk to friends and family. Many even go to therapy, these so-called therapists, psychologists, psychiatrists, sociologists, or even see multiple therapists. But nevertheless, their issue do not seem to improve. This has actually occurred with many of you that say you was going to be a secure party creditor. You come up with excuses. Excuses. You don't want to pay a donate a small amount of something that's going to alter your life, change your life for the better if you apply it accordingly? Why? Because you are blocking your own remedy with your thinking. Your problem is not me. Your problem is not Donald Trump. Your problem is your mind. Your problem is your thinking. The two corporations, known as the Democratic Party and the Republican Party, is dictating your lives. Book of Proverbs 23 verse 7 says, "For as a man thinketh, so is he." See, you're afraid. You think negative. You think you're going to get negative results. Therefore, you think that into existence. Proverbs 4 and 23 says, "Keep thy heart," meaning your mind. Your mind is your real heart. What's between your two ears, with all diligence. For out of it are the issues of life. So if you think a negative and you think bad things are going to come your way, guess what? You think them into existence, and you're going to act a certain way that you're going to pull these things into your life. So you got to think positive thought. You got to chase negative thoughts out of your mind and move away from negative people. Get away from the naysayers. Oh, I don't become a secure party creditor. This is going to happen to you. You're going to get locked up. Your life is going to be miserable. Wait, aren't you miserable right now? Look at the condition that you're in right now. See, if you're all right, you're not looking for no remedy. It's when dishonor comes, but then it's often too late. Understand that. 2 Corinthians 10 verse 5 says, casting down imaginations, because you got all of these crazy imaginations about all of these awful things happen to you for becoming an SPC. And even high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of Yahweh and bringing into captivity every thought to obedience of Yahushua Christ. James 4 verse 7 says, submit yourselves therefore to Yahweh. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. But what are you doing? Everybody is online for a slice of the devil's pie. You don't want remedy. You want a slice of the devil's pie. You're putting your hope in Obama. Where did that lead you to? Now, many of you put your hope in Trump. These are corporations, folks. Democratic Party and Republican Party are two major corporations. You're putting your hope in the wrong thing. The mind is the most competent computer in the world, but it only functions on the input it receives. Understand that. There are two ultimate sources of information, brothers, family. The creative, life-producing word from the Most High, the Creator, and the counterfeit words of death and deception sent as a fiery dart by the enemy of your soul. Now, who are you going to listen to? This, You know, if any of you are suffering from these things, or if you know someone is suffering from this, and this is someone you care about, you might watch helplessly from the sidelines as he or she continue to be their own worst enemy because they suffer from self-negation, and they're blocking their remedy with their thinking, with their thought. They're so negative and cynical. She or he may seem to repeat in the patterns that are self-destructive, unable to hear or take others' advice, or they distant themselves and they're unreachable. It's a painful process to watch if this is a loved one, but many people are this way. But it's even more painful when it's you. When it's you, and yeah, I'm talking to you. And you're watching yourself this way. That's what's more painful. See, in my 20 years of experience as an enlightener, I've identified 6 personality traits that can, you know, stagnate and stall even the most deserving and lovable people. I need you to hear me, family. The last one on my list is the one that's least recognized, yet it's probably the worst. And I think it's the most powerful obstacle of them all. Now, shutting out all worldly focus and centering on your thoughts, on me, on holiness in your mind, should be your main prerogative. Now, it is essential that you protect your heart and not expose it to these damaging things that produce negative thinking within you. I don't care if your mother, if it's your father, if they're producing or engendering negative thoughts in your mind, you must protect your heart, meaning your mind, against it. It could be your spouse. Book of Proverbs 4:23. Stop listening to those that tell you that being a secured party creditor is a scam. Those are the naysayers. See, a mind under my influence will produce words and actions that create life in every area. My words are spirit and they are life. John 6:63. So you must believe, otherwise you're blocking your remedy, brothers and sisters. If you don't believe, you're going to get documents, you're going to sit on them, because you really don't believe and you're blocking your own remedy. So likewise, a carnal, unregenerated mind will produce words and actions that will end in death and decay. You must stop the negative thinking. Therefore, if you believe that you will get into some sort of trouble, you will think that into existence, because you will act out your thoughts. Understand that, beloved. So many have said an idle mind is the devil's workshop, but it's your responsibility to take every thought captive. 2 Corinthians 10:5. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. To choose to think on purely love, wholesome things. Philippians 4:8. See, your mind is continually active. It is a life-changing tool, family. Your mind is a life-changing tool. It can be used for good or it can be used for evil. It can produce life or it can produce death or cause death. Let me rephrase that. Cause death. See, the choices you make on a moment-to-moment basis will determine what your focus will be. So, if you make a bad choice, situation is going to end up bad. So, if you want to become a secured party creditor, but have not because of what someone that doesn't know any damn thing about how this works or someone else that tried it, and then they didn't take the appropriate steps or do what they were supposed to do, and they're telling you, well, that's a scam, then you are actually allowing someone else to control your thinking, and you're going to be in the same old place 5 years from now, if not worse. And then you're going to reach out when you go into dishonor. So I'm going to bring this to a close, but before I do, I want to go over, there are 6 obstacles to growth. And they are, number 1, you can't see the path. This will block your growth. When you've spent years living a certain way with a negative mindset, that way becomes your reality and your worldview. You see everything from a negative perspective. Other people seem to be living on a different planet, and you can't understand how they've gotten there. It's hard to obtain something that you can't even imagine. Your fear has led you to failure. That's number 1. Number 2, you're a walled off. What I mean by that is you've actually built a wall around yourself from the outside world. You're growing up feeling unloved, unaccepted, on an unsafe, as an unsafe child, and then you erect walls around yourself for protection. Those walls are helpful in childhood, but in adulthood, they block out the people who can actually help you the most. So you're blocking the Tazadaqs out. You're blocking out those that could actually help you. It can be difficult to trust people who could be actually supporting you. So you find yourself safe, but alone. And I respectfully say this happens to many of our sisters. Single parent homes. So you're trapped within walls that are holding you back. But Tazadaq Shaw is only here to help the people right now. Help the people to see that there are 2 major corporations that are ruling your lives that you refer to as Democratic Party and Republican Party. These are corporations that should be controlled by the people, but they are oligarchies that manipulate the people. A few people, I want you to think about this. Think about this, what I'm about to say. There's a few people, a small body of people that sit down and they form statutes. They form codes. They form rules. They form regulations. And then they make decisions for all of the other millions of people. And then they say, this is law. Even if the people don't agree with it, they say, this is law. Can't you see something's wrong with that, brother? Get your mind right, King. Can't you see something's wrong with that? Can't you see that the people outnumber the small? I'm not advocating overthrow government. I'm advocating replace it. But the government is not doing its job. That is the duty of the people. That's what I'm about. A just system. Otherwise, you're just ice at 32 degrees, frozen. Understand that. So, brothers and sisters, a few people, a small body, sit down and they form these things, and the rest of the people follow this because they label it law. It is not law. It is not law. It is exactly what it says it is. It is codes, it is statute, it is rules, it is regulation, it is color of law. It's not law. How have you broken the law if you have not injured another man or woman? How have you broken the law if you have not damaged someone else's property? How have you broken the law if you have not stolen or created mischief in a contract? That's a question, and I want you to think about those questions. If there's no corpus delicti, how have I broken the law? My honor. If you have not done this, you have not broken the law for educational purposes. You have violated their color of law that the two corporations that control you told you was law. A few people control millions. If you do not agree with their public policies that they call law, then it is time to replace them. Number three, I'm almost finished. Almost finished. You get comfortable with being uncomfortable. You get comfortable with being uncomfortable, and this is blocking your remedy. And this is why you can't change, and this is why you're stuck. Self-destructive or damaging life patterns can be so entrenched that they become a part of who you are. No matter what's wrong in your life, you can get accustomed to it. You can get comfortable to it. See, our brains store life patterns, and we have a natural tendency to settle into them. We are who we are. And on some level, we get comfortable with that, even if it makes us miserable. So you have people that are married, but they hate each other. You have people that are married and they sleep in different bedrooms. Because why? You get comfortable with being uncomfortable. You have people that know what the two major corporations are doing to them with their corrupt politicians, but you're comfortable with it. You know it's wrong. You know something's wrong, but you're comfortable with it. So the idea of changing can feel very discomforting and scary. You fear it. See, it feels easier and safer to choose the devil that you know than the God that you don't know. So, though you have become comfortable with being a debtor and a slave, you know it's not right. You're saying right now, you know what? That brother's right. Or you watch my video for the first time, you're saying, where in the hell has this guy been? Because what he's saying is right. But you're comfortable with it. So right now, what you should do is become a secured party creditor before something bad happens and you are in dishonor. Do the work now. You're already in a bad situation, but you're comfortable with it because you've accepted failure. Fourth thing is depression. Depression interferes with growth. Depression stunts or even stops your growth in three important ways. It saps your energy and your motivation, which makes it harder to take on a challenge because you're depressed. It makes you isolate yourself so that you have less support to change. It makes you feel hopeless. So there seems no point in trying to change because you're depressed. The fifth thing is anger. Anger. Scripture said anger blows out the light of the mind. You anger at yourself. Self-directed anger has a way of breaking you down, family. It breaks you down like drops of water on a stove. There's a gradual erosion of your self-worth. How can you change when you don't feel your worth, the effort that it requires to change? And now, in conclusion, I give you the big one. Number six, past mistakes and misdeeds. This is the major obstacle. This is the major thing that keeps you stuck and it blocks you from being great. Past mistakes or misdeeds. Living in the past. The past is not real anymore. The only reality is right now. Is what you do right now. So in order to truly change, family, you have to acknowledge and face your own painful history. Who have you hurt? Forgive yourself. Go to them, ask for forgiveness. Forgive yourself. You must forgive yourself. What damage have you done to yourself or others? You must forgive yourself. Who's hurt you? You must forgive them. If you hold on to the hurt, you're not going to be free. You got to let it go. If someone's hurt you, you got to let it go. The guilt and pain that can result from looking at the past is a powerful force that can hold back even the most courageous person, the most courageous people. See, I've seen that this factor alone is a tremendous obstacle, a tremendous barrier in the recovery of anyone who has a personality disorder. You may have borderline personality disorder. You may be bipolar. You may be a narcissist or what have you. Looking to the past will hold you back. Or any other long-standing destructive life pattern. So, if you catch even a glimpse of how your past choices or mistakes have affected others, it may be so painful and guilt-inducing that you immediately look away. And there, you are right back where you started. So forgive yourself, forgive others. Stop blocking your remedy. If you want to become a creditor, if you want guidance, email me. Creditors, debtors, contracts at yahoo.com. Or go to the website www.creditors-debtors-contracts-and-commerce.org. Read the on-screen information. Donate. I'll be in touch with you by email. Leave your first, middle, last name, and address, and a phone number. Someone will be in contact with you. Do the work now. Become an SPC now before you go in dishonor. Stop blocking your remedy. Stop listening to the naysayers. Do the work now before the problems come. Because the problems will come. They're always coming. But what do you do when you face adversity? If you want to handle something big, you handle it while it's small. Do the work now. You make that small investment that will possibly alter your life if you do what is right. So with that, family, thank you for listening. I love you. Share this video. Like this video. All praises to the Most High. Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. All of you out there, if you're learning this, I pray that you're teaching others. And remember, the people are the true power. If the people unify, if the people unite, if the people stop being afraid. My name is Tazadaq. I'm going to say Shalom Yasha Allah. Shalom, family.